Number one, we are born with the nature and the life of God. And it is impossible for us to see color.
My name is Christine Motio. I joined Bethany in September 2016. And since then, my life has been upward and forward. In December 2018, my husband began complaining of a very sharp pain on the right side, and it increased and persisted. And later on, we decided that we should go and seek for professional help and see a doctor. We went to Nairobi Hospital in January. My husband was checked. They did an ultrasound on him. They did an MRI and a CT scan. And two things that the doctor was checking on, he wanted to see whether his kidneys were okay, and they were checking also for prostate cancer. And the first time we went to the doctor's office, he was using medical terms. So at that time, he didn't want us to know the kind of test that he was doing and what he wanted to arrive at. So the tests were done. We came back to Nanyuki. And when we came back to Nanyuki, a few days later, my man of God, Pastor Elijah, called us for a meeting as a department. I'm the leader of communications department and official attendant department. And when we met our man of God, he gave us his expectations for the year and gave us instructions of what he wanted done in the department. So I received the instruction, and one of the instructions that he gave us was for us to do the church, the signpost for the church. And I thought, the Holy Spirit communicated to me and told me, this one you are going to do it, not as a department, but as an individual. I got so excited at the thought of, you know, being the person as an individual who was going to take care of the church signpost. And at that time, I stopped treating that money as money. I treated it as a seed. So I heeded to the instruction as an individual, and I sent the money to my man of God. When I sent the money to my man of God, the same day that I sent the money for the signpost, was the same day, like 2 minutes later, I received a call from Nairobi Hospital, and we were told to go back to Nairobi Hospital very quickly, because they had realized that there was a problem with my husband's kidneys. I was at church. And quickly, because my man of God has taught us about the Holy Spirit quickly communicated to me and told me, Christine, you have nothing, absolutely nothing to worry about, because your husband is well. You have ransomed his life with your seed that you have put on the ground. And immediately I got excited, so excited. You know, it's like somebody telling you, you don't have to worry about anything. That's what the Holy Spirit was telling me. You have ransomed his life, Proverbs 13 verse 8. And immediately, by the time I went to meet my husband and break the news, there was nothing anymore to worry about. I just went and told him, and the Holy Spirit he was faithful enough to even teach me what to tell him. So by the time I got to him, it was no longer a struggle. So the following week, because that was on a Wednesday, on a Monday, we went to Nairobi. My husband was checked, and true to what the Holy Spirit said, my husband's kidneys were found to be functional. Can you imagine, from kidneys that were unfunctional to kidneys that were functional? And I remember when he was in the theater, when they were doing the tests, they could not believe it, because these were the same people who called us back. They could not believe it. They kept changing each other in the room. You know, they would call some of their colleagues to come and check and be sure that what they had seen was no longer there anymore. Of course, we knew what the Lord had done. Praise be to God for that miracle. Another one I want to attest that came about as a result of my giving. Don't forget, my man of God has been, you know, amazing, teaching us about giving, teaching us about the Holy Spirit. And this one also happened a week ago. I'm talking about a week ago. We were celebrating our first decade as a church, and we were holding a meeting at church. And I happened to be seated in that meeting, and we were asked, we were asked to give towards the cleaning of the linen at church. And immediately the Holy Spirit, being the sweet person that he is, asked me to take care of that bill. And I just fronted myself and I said, guess what? I'm going to cater for the washing of the linens of the church. Not knowing, again, I was going to ransom the life of my husband again, this time around, the second time. When I was asked to pay, I paid. I was diligent in what I was asked to do. And I remember on the same Friday that I paid for the washing of the linens of the church as an instruction from the Holy Spirit, my husband called me from Nairobi and he told me that he was unwell. I told him, don't worry about anything. You have nothing to worry about. You're healed in the name of Jesus. When he came back to Nanyuki, surely he was very sick. Again, we rushed him to the hospital late at night. And by the time we got to Cottage Hospital, they straight away took him and started treating him and, you know, doing lab tests and the rest of the things. I want you to know that he was passing a lot of blood in his stool. So it was not a simple case, it was a serious case. The Holy Spirit told me, Christine, you have nothing to worry about. You give towards the washing of the church's linen. You have nothing to worry about. You ransomed the life of your husband with your giving. Then this was the second time again that the Holy Spirit was saving the life of my husband out of my giving. Thank you so much, Pastor Elijah. I mean, what can I say as a person? What can I ever give you for the teachings that you have given us, the way you have impacted the word of God into our spirits, the way the Lord has used you to train us? I just want to say thank you.